There's a live look at the 8 Humber National Championships for soccer as the Hawks continue their quest for number 9. Hello and welcome to Ontario Soccer Centre in Vaughan, Ontario for the second quarterfinal match of the OCAA Men's Provincial Championship. The host Humber Hawks will take on the Durham Lords. I'm Andrew Milani alongside my broadcasting partner Zach Benoit. And Zach, Humber comes into this match after a historic regular season in which they set a new high mark in 56 goals in the province en route to another division championship, but they don't hang banners for division championships at Humber now, do they?
No, they do not. And out there at midfield, you see there the national titles they have, last one coming in 2021. And you said it, you know, Humber outscored the West Division opponents 56-5. So really showing their dominance this year.
Yeah, and basically average of half a goal allowed per game. So defense and offense both running on an incredibly high level. Of course, led by a number of players. Luco Cello, notable, basically almost a guarantee for a goal and assist every game.
I mean, you got to look at it. Luco Cello, Damian Kay, both tied for the most, scored 10 goals each, and just really showing their dominance. But another thing was they ran the table. They won 10 straight games, finishing with a perfect 10-0 record. So, I mean, you know, the Hawks, they're looking poised. They want to go back there. They want to defend not only their provincial title, but the national title.
This is an impressive program that head coach Michael Aquino has put together here for the Humber Hawks. And the quest for that next national title, of course, continues here. You got to win provincials first. And the Durham Lords pose an interesting challenge here today for the Humber Hawks, finishing fourth in their division of 5-3-2 record, 25 goals for, 11 against. Let's see what the Hawks have against them as they get ready for the national anthem. Players exchanging fist bumps at midfield, and Zach, we mentioned that there's some top players for Humber that helped lead the way, but of course this is a balanced attack as well. 8 players on the squad with 3 goals or more this season, where basically attacking threats can basically come from anywhere. Yeah, tough challenge here for the Durham Lords.
Yeah, you said it. I mean, it's going to be a good match either way, but Humber has just been so dominant for so many years that you got to look at a little bit of everybody on that attacking core. I mean, they do a very good job just passing the ball around, letting everybody get involved. And it doesn't matter if it's been a fifth-year player or a first-year, everybody contributes.
That is indeed the truth. This Humber team has that kind of next-man-up mentality.
And they've looked really dominant, you know.
There's a look at the Durham Lords, the visiting team here, led by head coach Dave Ashfeld. We mentioned before, finishing fourth in their division during a playoff win against the Redeemer Royals from the other conference. There's a look at the Humber Hawks.
Yeah, and just a look, you know, last time Durham Lords had a really strong standing was in 2017-18. They were actually the OCAA gold medal champions, so it could be pose a little bit of a threat to the Hawks. We'll see how it pans out, but, you know, some returning players, some players new, should be a good one. But just to kind of put into perspective, Andrew, of how dominant this Humber Hawks soccer program is, Humber has won 9 of the last 11 OCAA championships. But hold on, there's more than just that.
Oh, no.
They've won 6 out of the last 9 national, yes, national championships.
Batting .667 nationals over the last 9 years, that's not bad.
Genuinely, that's pretty impressive. That's a very impressive stat to have. And it's going to be a good game all the way around. Like you mentioned, you know, you got to look at fifth-year player Luke Uccello. You got to look at Damian Kay. But also, don't sleep on number 15, Danny Medeiros, who's, you know, he's new to the program, but he's kind of cementing his footing in being a dominant player for the Hawks. In the case of, he's kind of shadowed, you know, Luke Uccello, Damian Kay. And they've kind of brought him under their wing just to be that next top playmaker and next top goal scorer.
Yeah, certainly he's been a threat at that kind of wing mid position. 3 goals, 3 assists on the season. He's definitely a threat here and cementing himself as a big part of this Humber program. There's a live look there. Don't sleep on Cadell Thomas either. 9 goals, 6 assists. It's like 10 matches.
It's like a three-headed monster up there with Damian Kay, Luke Uccello, Cadell Thomas. And then you throw in the youngster and Danny Medeiros just learning from them. I mean, so much depth with this team. It's very scary.
Cadell Thomas, when he gets it on net, he's shooting .680.
That's just, I mean, ridiculous in a sense. It's going to be a good game, and I'm very, very excited for this one to start.
And we are underway here at Ontario Soccer Center. Humber with the first possession. Durham getting that full court press going on early, not wanting to give Humber any time or space.
Yeah, I was going to say, you know, right off the bat, Durham just sending 3-4 players up. Just trying to take as much field away from the Hawks as possible.
And we'll see if that will set this tone for the rest of the game. It's going to be a goal kick here for Humber. Humber, as we know, they like to play that possession game, like to start their offense from the back and slowly work their way up. Not taking too many chances, but staying aggressive nonetheless. There's Danny Medeiros with his first touch. Cadell Thomas wins that back.
There's just a lot of pressure from Durham, right? We said they pushed that pace at the opening kickoff, and they've continued to do so. They've had majority of their team just on the attacking side.
Long ball for Cadell Thomas. Able to keep that one in bounds, cross it. That'll be intercepted and cleared out by the Lords. Frantic pace in the opening minute of this match.
And just before kickoff, you know, we thought the rain was going to continue to fall down very heavy. You know, the pace has kind of slowed down a little bit with the weather. So look for that to maybe be an impact if it picks back up or if it even stops.
Yeah, it's something we haven't even mentioned yet. The elements here in Vaughan's, a little bit of rain here. Was a little bit heavier early on. We'll see if that changes. There's rain in the forecast basically all day that we're here at Ontario Soccer Center until the evening. So we'll see how much of that wet grass, that wet turf, plays a factor here during the rest of this match. Humber working through the back end. It's Keegan Wilson. Low give and go. Medeiros looking for Thomas. Crossed into the box. Stays in somehow. Could be an opportunity here. Passed out, but that will be snuffed out by the Lords. Ball won back by Osman Hussein. Out of bounds. It's going to be a throw-in for Durham.
And just impressive, right? I mean, the attack. We talk so much of how strong this attack is for the Hawks, but they also just do a good job of just incorporating some of their midfielders and some of their defenders on the attack as well.
And we've seen that with the women's team a lot this year, too. They were able to have those fullbacks really play as wingbacks and able to get into the attack while helping out on defense. And it's a tough thing to defend if you get it right.
Exactly. And just before, you know, the play at the net, we saw number 21, Noah McIntyre, actually push all the way up from that backfield side onto the attack with Luca Uccello.
Humber player knocked down as Luca Pinto. It's going to be a free kick here for Humber. Hussein turns back. Keegan Wilson will get us started. He had time and space, and he took advantage. Moving up. We'll stay Humber ball. Running towards the box. Head of steam. Shoots. Big save there. It's going to bounce out of bounds. Going to stay Humber ball, but a great opportunity there. First real scoring chance.
Another look at it here. Damian Kay, just phenomenal moves down the line. And a hard kick, trying to tuck it into that close post, but goaltender there to cover it. And, I mean, that's the Hawks offense we're so used to seeing. Just nonstop aggression.
Cello passed it off. Ball flutters out of the box. Kick there by Cadell Thomas. That one missed, but not by much.
Yeah, and, you know, we've been talking a lot about the Hawks side. We'll just take a quick look at the Durham Lords side. They actually defeated the Redeemer Royals 6-2 at home on Saturday. And that allowed them to qualify for the championship. And obviously, they get the first crack at the juggernaut of a team that is Humber. And, you know, they're a pretty well-rounded scoring team. Five players tied for the regular season lead in team goals with three. And then a league all-star, Skylar Gray, out of Ajax, was one of those. So, I mean, this is a good Durham Lords team. A little bit of a rocky season for them. So, but coming into the provincial tournament, this is a very good test against a good Humber Hawks team.
Yeah, playoffs is a fresh start. Anything could happen. Cadell Thomas had a chance at the edge of the box, lost it. Passed up for Luca Uccello. He couldn't get a hold of it. It's going to stay in bounds. Cleared out. Managed to keep that in. Out of bounds, Humber ball. Throw and taken quickly. Hussein passed it to McIntyre in the middle. Cross looking for Danny Medeiros, won't find him. Durham can't get it out. Uccello passed it back to Medeiros. He tried to get the give and go going with Uccello, couldn't. Keegan Wilson now. Alex Mazarski. Hawks trying to find an opening here. McIntyre went for the through ball. None of his teammates were ready, though. Guye, the Durham keeper, blasted out. Could be a chance here for Durham. They've got time and space. Christian Forteau. Can't find his teammate. He's looking for DeAndre Watkiss. Humber in possession right by their 18-yard box. Keegan Wilson now. Big cross up field. Humber trying to keep this in the attacking third.
Yeah, just arriving here in the seventh minute, and it's been a pretty evenly matched game so far. Humber just having majority of the chances and just looking really, really strong. But on the side of Durham, they kind of pushed that aggression early on, and they looked like they could maybe give Humber a little bit of a run for their money in the early stages, but Humber solidified it.
And it seems we've seen Durham kind of take a step back from the aggression that we saw off that opening play. Maybe it was something to try and get Humber off their game, but they've kind of gone back into a little bit of a shell here. Cadell Thomas looking for the through ball. DiBartolo now, he'll pass it back.
Yeah, you said it best, you know, just trying to get something to throw off this the juggernaut of a team off their game plan. And it looked like it worked for about the first three-ish, four-ish minutes. But then once Humber really kind of solidified themselves, they have looked like the team of old.
Absolutely. They say with the top players in really every league, you can't truly stop them. You can only contain them. Seems to be the plan here for Durham. Humber will move back to their own side of midfield. Keegan Wilson will take a run. Slips through the defense. He's knocked down. No call. Humber will hang on. It's McIntyre now. Hussein. Pass quickly to Uccello. See what he's got. Cadell Thomas, a little flick into the box. No good.
Yeah, and somebody you never want to sleep on is number two in that backfield, Keegan Wilson. And, I mean, he has so much speed. It's kind of scary sometimes if you're an attacker.
It could be very disarming for other teams. We've seen it a few times before where he just slices his way through traffic and manages to get a scoring chance, sometimes even a goal.
Yeah, I'm very curious how quickly he can actually get upfield if you were to run his full. Like, I want to say, you know, maybe 7 seconds. It's just how fast he is.
Medeiros in the box. Could have been a great opportunity there, but knocked away.
That's the youngster, Danny Medeiros, right there. And I said, you got to watch out for him. He's taken a lot of lessons from Luca Uccello and Damian Kay up front. And he's poised to be a very good player for years to come here for the Humber Hawks.
Only his first year in the program already. A starter playing on that left mid position. Ball bounced right through the captain's legs there. Goude Jimmy. Cello trying to control it. Gives it away though. Chance here, player knocked down right by the edge of the box. That's going to be a free kick.
Wilson, you know, just got a little bit too aggressive.
Referee not reaching into her pocket for a card just yet. Humber electing for a three-man wall. Right by that corner of the 18-yard box. The question here, Durham, do they go cross or do they go straight for goal?
I mean, I guess it's a good opportunity. You're in very good field position to go for the goal. So, I mean, that's something that you should try to play into your advantage right now as you're trying to go for this kick.
Low shot. They'll be scooped up in the hands of the keeper.
And I'm not sure if you can hear it here, partner, but as we continue on in this game and just another look at the shot here, an easy save for Zmeta, but you can hear the rain starting to pick up a little bit more. So, again, something that can play factor into the conclusion of this game.
Just a little bit more to think about here for either side. I'm really trying to pick up the pace here, trying to get something going. Player open on that far side. Cuts into the middle. Loses it, cleared out by the Lords. Will stay in bounds. Humber has it back though. Hussein tried to advance that ball, couldn't. Good stop there. Hussein's got it now. Pass it up to Cadell Thomas. Steps around to his right. Nice little move. Great ball there. DiBartolo fouled on the far side. It's going to be a free kick for the Hawks.
You hear the side, the coach of the Durham Lords. He's getting very vocal with his team because they understand the magnitude of this right now. You're going up against the team that ran the table going 10-0. So it's a very big thing if you could possibly upset them.
Whoever gets the first goal here is going to make a big difference. Player setting up for the free kick. Here it is. Looks good. Just knocked out of bounds. It's going to be a goal kick for Durham.
Yeah, I believe that was Damian Kay with the header. Just trying to get it. We'll take another look at it right here. Yeah, it looked like it was Damian Kay trying to get the head on the ball. Got it and just kind of flew a little bit wide.
Great touch there by Uccello looking for Dave Bartolo. Knocked down again.
And that's a yellow card.
First of the game.
Skylar Gray. Oh, excuse me. I might have got my numbers mixed up. I'm trying to make up the jersey number. I thought it was number 10. 18, actually. Paul Valera. Mappelling with the yellow card. Number 18, not Skylar Gray. Mappelling.
So a card in the 15th minute. He's going to have to watch out. Uccello sending up for the free kick. He goes for goal, but that one just a little too high.
A lot of power behind the kick. These are the times, right? You kind of miss that free kick specialist in Federico Leal. But, I mean, Luca Uccello is still a phenomenal soccer player.
Not a bad chance. Can't hit on that. Durham trying to get something going here. Player knocked down. It's going to be a foul. Keegan Wilson getting called for it. Referee trying to calm things down here. Of course, there's a lot of passion, a lot of fire in a playoff game. You got to keep that under control. It's going to be Emerald getting ready for the free kick once again. We saw last time out he had a good chance on net with that low shot. This time he goes for the cross. Oh, that one could have been ugly, but kept out. It's going to be a corner now for the Durham Lords.
And I believe it was the header. And yep, going for that corner and a smart play. Heads up play by Holger to just keep that one out. And you can hear the rain just coming down even heavier now.
First corner kick for the Durham Lords. Humber gets ahead on it first again. Cleared out to midfield. Damien Kay giving chase. Can't reach it. Cadell Thomas will just let it bounce out of bounds, and he'll take, Medeiros rather, will take the throw in. Finds Damien Kay. He's going to make a run for it. Doesn't have much space, though, but that ball knocked out of bounds. It's going to be a corner kick for the Hawks. Still waiting on that first goal.
Both sides have had just really good chances. Just a matter of time, really, before the first one is scored.
Uccello's corner. Headed, but right to the keeper. Another opportunity there as we get our first listen of the Vuvuzela here at Soccer Center. The infamous Vuvuzela.
Just pulling up the weather forecast here for you. It looks like it's probably going to be these consistent rains for majority of the rest of the day. At least another hour, hour and a half.
McIntyre unloads. That one's blocked. Kay fires. That's in. 1-0 Humber. 18th minute.
And sensational play from Damian Kay.
He's got the moves too.
Nice little move on the sidelines. And he's just such a phenomenal player. Gets the first one for the Hawks. And I said it, it's only a matter of time before it happens. And right there, number 9, Gets it in the back of the net. Another look at it here. Off the rebound of the player. Just gets around his defender. Left foot, too. Tucking it in that right post. I don't know who's better, the goal or the celebration afterwards there, Andrew.
Both were equally impressive in this commentator's mind. So I'm up 1-0 early. Team that scored an average of 5.6 per game. You figured they'd have to score one here eventually, and it didn't take long.
I mean, scoring 56 in the regular season, yeah. Right? One has to come. But just great play. Humber, this is why they've just been so good. Rather, the defending national, not only provincial, but national champions. They expect perfection, and perfection shows.
Bit of a miscue there by Keegan Wilson. Durham's going to take over with a throw-in. As we enter the 20th minute. Reset here for the Lords. They'll try again. Going to be Humber ball. Quickly get that ball to midfield. Damien K battling for it. Temper starting to flare a little bit here.
I mean, you hear the players having a little bit of a kerfuffle there. Leave.
So we got some more heavy downpour here in Vaughn.
The captain on the side of Durham, you know, telling Damien K, hey, let's have a friendly game here. And he said it, those words exactly, let's have a friendly game.
A nice friendly playoff
nice,
match.
Nice friendly, respectful playoff match.
I mean, I'm all for respect, but friendly, I don't know. Not during this time, at least.
Not, okay. It's the Canadian in me, you know?
Sorry.
There you go. See, you're learning.
Well, I hope so. I was born here.
We have fun over here at HSN.
Sometimes.
This game just kind of breezing by just into the 21st minute right here.
Whistle blowing that play dead. Free kick here for the Hawks. Now you got to feel Durham's got to be feeling a little bit desperate at this point. They're down 1-0 in an opposition field. National championship nonetheless.
Yep.
And so they got to be pressing here for a goal. You want to get one before halftime.
For sure. And you know what? Like, you look at the offense. We talk so much highly about the offense and the defense. But once you get past those, score on the goaltender is not an easy task either. Holger is a meta.
Captain unloads that one way high and wide.
Like I was saying, Holger is a meta, a phenomenal goaltender. And started 6 games this year. 5 goals allowed, 6 wins, 15 saves, and goals against average under 1. So, I mean, it just shows how good he is.
And the way Humber split it this year was really he got the heavier load. He got a lot of those tougher matches as well. To have goals against under 1 is extremely impressive. Maduros was looking for Cadell Thomas with that cross. It's going to stay Humber ball. About halfway through this first half. Maduros turns back. Here's Hussein. A little bit of contact there. It'll be a free kick here for the Hawks. Mczarski looks like he'll take it. Good looking free kick, looking for DiBartolo. Damien K comes up with it. In the middle for Uccello. He'll fire, that's blocked. Cadell Thomas unloads. Well, that one misses way wide for the goal kick.
One after another. And you listed off all three of the highly touted offensive guys for the Hawks. Each having a good opportunity there. And it comes in waves, right? Mm-hmm. The first attack, they get the shot on, but they're always there for the rebound. And if that rebound doesn't come in, well, got to look out because they'll send another.
Yeah, it's really been the story of the season for this Humber Hawks men's soccer team. This offense just coming in waves. And just when you think it's done, well, watch out. They'll be back. Medeiros into the middle. Wilson will pass it back to his keeper. He'll have to get rid of it quickly. He does. So Cadell Thomas can't keep that in.
Thomas tried his best to keep that in play, unable to.
Wilson almost falling down. He'll stay up. Hussein to McIntyre. Looking for DiBartolo. Just not enough on that pass. Hussein, nice job breaking up that play. He's got reinforcements now. Let's see what Hussein can do here. McIntyre gives it back to Hussein. Cross. He's looking for Damien K. Couldn't find him. That pass will get away from all the Lords. Right to the keeper. Holger Exameda.
And really, now that they're up, they can kind of just control the pace of this game. They're really just going to kind of dictate how they want it to play out. And if Durham chases at all, you know, that's when Humber will just strike and get another one. That's what makes this team so dangerous.
Yeah, there's no point in pressing too hard, trying to force a goal when you're up by this point and really have been dominating a lot of this game. So they can kind of sit back a little bit and just kind of play their game. Ball cleared out. Cello's throw in. Thomas keeping it in. Low cross. Damien K. passive. Shot. That one just missed the net.
Just going wide. Another great opportunity for the Hawks. Luca Pinto this time stepping up. Looked like he tried to tuck it into that close post. Ooh, mere matter of inches, Andrew.
Could have been 2-0, but we're stuck here at 1-0. 27th minute. This first half just flying by here at Ontario Soccer Center. Not surprising to see a lot of umbrellas, a lot of ponchos out there in the stands, given this wet weather we're having.
What do you mean? It's a beautiful day.
Well, under here, sure.
Yeah, when I have to make the walk of shame to the car, it's not going to be fun.
Looking for Uccello. Great ball. Be even better defense to break up that play.
That's the thing. You know, Durham had that little bit of a rocky year, you know, finishing just in the middle of the pack, but they're still a good team. Can't really count them out at all.
Cadell Thomas was looking for Uccello again. Be a Humber throw in. Mczarski with it. Turns around, passes to the keeper. DeBartolo advances the ball. Cutting to the middle. Another chance here. Trying to get this ball in the box. Crosses it up. Looking for Cadell Thomas. He gets a foot on it. Tries to keep it in. Hussein with it. Right at the edge of the box. Passes it up. A little give and go here. Ball bouncing all over the place in the Durham box.
Man, just a
no real solid goal scoring opportunity there for the Hawks, though.
Yeah, I mean, like we said, comes in waves. So you can never really count them out. Doesn't matter who has the ball. If they take a shot, you always got to look for that next attacker up.
And who's going to be the next man on the attack here for the Humber Hawks? Wilson, nice little touch to pass, to go back, rather. Gzarski now, back to Wilson. Nice little touch by Hussein.
Nifty little footwork there.
Medeiros knocked down. Obvious free kick. And Tyrell Thompson's going to get talking to by the referee. A little warning next time should result in a card if that happens again. Here we go. McIntyre looking for Cadell Thomas. Can't find him. Cello giving chase. Medeiros now. High cross. It's going to find its way into the midst of the keeper.
I just want to say that was a very impressive cross. I mean, pinpoint accuracy right there from Medeiros.
No kidding. Cross to the box, but Exameda holds on to that one. Keegan Wilson knocked down.
You know, frustration's coming out a little bit here. The side of Durham. And it's understandably so. I mean, Humber just really just, they've taken control. Once that first goal is scored, that's just kind of how their play style is. They just take control. And they wait for the other team just to make the mistakes.
High pass to Uccello. Tries to flick it to his teammate. Can't get it. McIntyre, nice ball there for Damian Kay. He's got some space coming in on that left side. Cuts over. McIntyre can't hang on to that ball. Hussein passes it back. Big slide tackle there. That's an obvious foul. Should result in a card. And there it is. That's his second yellow card, so Durham's going to have to play the rest of this game a man short.
That's a big one right there. Once again, Paul Valer Mapelling. You just can't do that, especially with a card already. And that's just, it's just going to add just more difficulty to this attempt by Durham to try to get back in this game. Humber, I mean, they're just playing their game at this point, Andrew. I mean, nothing to really shame them for whatsoever. But if you're the side of Durham, that's just something you cannot do.
Just makes that climb uphill into a mountain, basically, for the rest of this match.
Down a man, like you said, the rest of the match. It's going to be very, very tough. And, you know, Humber, they're just, you know, grinning from ear to ear right now. This is exactly what they wanted.
Medeiros knocked down. Another foul. Referee reaches into her pocket. Another yellow awarded here to the Lords. Two, rather.
Two yellow cards. One to number 16, Christian Fortier. And then I believe number 26 as well, Tyrell Thompson. So
Denny Medeiros looks like he's in some serious pain here.
Yeah, you heard when he went down. It's just the scream. It was the ear piercing almost when he went down.
Going to get some medical attention here.
And like we said, the frustrations for the side of Durham just starting to come out. You can't keep putting yourself in a hole like this. It's just going to make the game so much more difficult for you.
Medeiros getting back on his feet. Durham about to make a substitution here. It looks like Christian Forteau is going to check out. And in is number 8, William Lydon.
Appears that Medeiros will stay in the game? I don't know. Looks like
no substitution being made yet.
It just takes some time on the sidelines.
That header just past the post, but another excellent opportunity for the Hawks with 10 minutes left to go in the half.
Another just excellent, like you said, excellent opportunity. The cross, defender just gets the head on it. Close though, close to an own goal.
No kidding.
And glad to see Danny Medeiros just kind of running back on the field there.
Luca Uccello to take another free kick. Kick is up. A couple players tried to get their heads on it, couldn't. Cleared up high. Medeiros first on it. Durham trying to get a counterattack going. Humber gets it right back, though. Cadell Thomas. There's DeBartolo. Medeiros wide open on that left side. Finds Damian Kay. Trying to get around through traffic in the box. Low cross, cleared out by the Lords. Not too far though, they're not out of danger yet.
Just good play, they just continue to push this attack, Andrew. They're not giving anything up.
Cross into the box, but right to the midst of the keeper. He's bobbled it a little bit, but he hangs on. Big kick. Almost in the Humber attacking third. Durham looking for the tying marker. Here come the Hawks the other way. Hussein will just give that one away. He's looking for Uccello. Cello with it. Cadell Thomas. Can't get around his man. Still on him, though. Ball will be cleared out. It's going to be a throw-in for Humber.
37th minute. And we'll just be entering into the 38th minute, actually. But, you know, from both sides, Humber, they've just done a really, really good job to just get under the skin of the Lords. And for Durham, you know, you just got to try to lay off a little bit. Getting the frustrations out on the field, it's not going to help.
Free kick coming for the Hawks. We're still with it. Wilson turns back. Look at the restart going here on offense. Zuccello. Looking for Thomas, can't find him. Hussein. Thomas. McIntyre moves it up to Medeiros. To Hussein in the middle. Crossed over to McIntyre. He's got plenty of space. Cross into the box. Broken up by Lores. Big kick there. But way high goes that opportunity.
Ball goes sailing onto the field in the back. And, I mean, if he got on top of it a little bit more, what a strike that would have been.
He was certainly not lacking power on that opportunity.
Tegan Marks makes his way onto the field, number two. And just a couple times, something I've noticed off screen, after the plays, you know, Danny Medeiros still kind of favoring the leg a little bit, just kind of hunching over, probably just feeling the pain still. But he's fighting through. He knows how big of a moment this is. In these playoffs, he wants to be there every step of the way for his team.
We'll see how that plays out for the rest of the game and the rest of this tournament as well. Damien Kay. It's McIntyre. Plenty of space once again. Medeiros, he's looking for Uccello. Won't reach him. Under 5 minutes left to go in the first half. Humber leading 1-0. Ball will sail out of bounds. It's going to be a throw-in for the Hawks. Cross to Medeiros. Cuts into the middle.
Just good opportunities again. Just really using the whole field here as Humber. Just trying to find some opening. And if they can't see it, they'll just rotate it to the other side. And it's just, they're doing a great job of it.
In the box now is Damien Kay. Cross. Still in there. Cleared up by the Lords. A couple players battling for the ball. Big clearing opportunity. Could be a chance here. Goalie can't hang on, but he manages to snag it there. Great job by Eximida.
And Holger. Whew, doing some great job in net right now. Probably the best chance that the Lords have had all day to tie it. And he just shuts it down.
Definitely the best chance here for the Lords this afternoon. With a man short nonetheless. I'm just going to try and add one more here before the whistle blows for halftime. Crossing for Uccello off the head of one of the Lords' defenders will be a corner kick.
And just another look at this save, and I tell you, I'm impressed. I am impressed. Gets the one hand on it and just jumps on it right after, not allowing any rebound to come up. And he's, you know, hasn't had a lot of action, but he still looks phenomenal this year.
There to be counted on when he needs to be. Cross into the box. We're trying to clear it out. It's going to be another corner as we enter the 44th minute. Kick is up.
Almost a really nice play. Kind of a little bit of a design there. Keegan Wilson headers it inside the box again. And you can kind of see he was aiming towards that backside where Damian K was inches away from goal number two was K. You know, Damian K listed at 5'9". If he was 5'11", that extra inch maybe.
He would have been able to get ahead on that, yeah.
Got to put the rises in the shoes a little bit.
Some extra long cleats, perhaps. Thomas cross looking for K. Can't find him. Cleared out. Wynn's going to keep it in that side of midfield, though. Wynn really starting to pick up here at Ontario Soccer Center.
As the wind picks up, the rain kind of just continues to just fall. And like we said, it's going to be a pretty big element to try to overcome here in this game.
Two minutes of injury time to be added.
And we are now in those 2 minutes. Has just hit the 51st.
Chance here. But he was caught offside. William Lydon. Another look at that.
And yeah, just getting in behind the defense there. Unfortunate there for the side of Durham. Good break, though, for Humber.
Okay, we'll head that forward to Uccello. Can't quite get to that one. Thomas keeps that one in bounds. Nice little move to get his man off. Pressing for one more here before halftime. McIntyre. He's in the middle, got some space. Now Cadell Thomas, he's got plenty. Medeiros. Long cross into the box. Finds the head of one of the Lord's defenders, cleared out. Wilson with it.
But just look how pushed up Humber's back line is. Not even at midfield. They're already in the attacking zone on Durham's side.
Referee looked at her watch before. This could be their final opportunity. Fluttered past the net. Goal kick. Perhaps one more chance. Humber players retreating. That whistle signals halftime. Humber, one goal scored. The only goal we've seen so far in this match. And that came from the foot of Damian Kay.
And we said it, both sides, they're very good soccer teams. But Humber coming away with the edge. This is why they have ran the table going 10-0. But look at it here again. Damian Kay, just sensational play. And if I may add, an even better celebration. But, here we're going to take a quick look at that celebration as well there, Andrew.
A little extra treat.
Look at
this.
It
is.
Look at that. Having some fun out here in the rain. And then Durham, you know, late in that half, the best save. Zamata gets the hand on it and just pounces on the ball. right after. No rebounds given up, and that's a huge, huge save and a huge switch in momentum for the Hawks as they lead it here 1-0 after a half.
Yeah, that big save kept this one from being level going into halftime. We'll get a look at some of the stats here. Humber leading in just about every category except for saves, of course, but equal on – when it comes to shots on target, they lead, rather, 4-2.
Yeah, good attempts on both sides, but, you know, we got to wait here for the second half for the game to resume, Andrew.
This should be an interesting second half. We'll see what adjustment either side makes as they prepare for the rest of the tournament. We'll take a quick break for 15 minutes. Join us soon for the second half. Hello and welcome back to Ontario Soccer Center in Vaughan for half number two, match number two, quarterfinal number two between the Humber Hawks and the Durham Lords. I'm Andrew Milani, and now Manny Calra joining me in the broadcast booth. And Manny, what were your impressions of that first half?
The first half was a great half of the soccer game. Humber doing an exceptional job on the field, getting a couple of opportunities, getting the first goal on the board. Durham also doing a great job getting that opportunity, but Zameta able to hop onto that one opportunity Durham had in that later half of the first half. But both teams playing a strong half of the soccer game on both sides of the field. Humber obviously coming out on top, playing their traditional defense out, building on the offense. We'll see if Humber continues to use the same strategy moving forward.
Very strong possession game by the Humber Hawks in that first half. We're off to a quick start here in the second. Ball bouncing all over the place. We saw a little bit of the wind pick up in at the end of that first half. Seems to have died down a little bit, but the rain hasn't gone anywhere.
Yeah, the rain's kind of been continuing since it started on and off, and that's definitely going to also be a factor moving on to this game, Andrew.
And for the rest of the day as well, rain in the forecast basically until the evening while we're broadcasting games. So should continue to be an interesting factor here as this turf here just continues to get more and more slick. Another challenge here. Durham down a man after one of their players being awarded a red card. Double yellows for Paul Valerie Mapelling.
Yeah, most definitely. Another player to keep an eye out on, the Durham Lords, is number 26, who also has a yellow card and has also gotten a warning for the Durham Lords from the referee. So someone also to keep an eye out on moving forward in this game.
That player is Tyrell Thompson. Does not seem to be on the field right now, though he could easily be substituted right back in.
Yeah, I believe he was substituted at the very end of the first half just to make sure he can be utilized later on in the stages of the game by the coach. Smart decision, taking out one of your veteran players.
Danny Medeiros also staying in this game after he was fouled hard, kind of favoring that right leg, that right ankle area. Appears he will stay in this game, and hopefully he should stay in for Humber for the rest of this tournament.
Yeah, Danny Medeiros is such a workhorse on this team, and a testament to that was the injury. It chooses to remain in the game and has had a strong impact and has been a key player in terms of possession for the Hawks as well.
Absolutely. Another interesting note is that Humber, we've seen a lot of times they like to switch wings when you switch halves, but looks as if Medeiros and De Bartolo will stay on their sides. De Bartolo patrolling right mid, and Danny Medeiros patrolling left mid.
Yeah, both players versatile. They can swap on any given game day, as you mentioned. Allows Humber to have that ability to switch things up and keep things fresh or creative, either or, but both staying on their respective sides from the first half, and we'll see how Humber tries to switch that up, maybe moving forward or not.
Okuye, the Durham keeper, scooping that ball up, kicking it up to midfield. It's going to bounce away from number 10, Skylar Gray. One of the standouts here for the Durham Lords. De Bartolo trying to make a play on that one. Can't hang on. Uccello scooping that one with his foot, though. Nice ball here. Skylar Gray's on it. Could be an opportunity. Mizarski, though, cutting out that opportunity. Some great defense there by the center back.
Yeah, what a great run by Mizarski, the fifth-year veteran on this team, realizing the danger and making sure he was there for the support.
Cello losing it there. Gives chase, though. Late slide.
Yeah, that sliding tackle from Uccello is going to draw the whistle, I believe. And Durham will get an opportunity here for a free kick.
No talking to by the referee, so a terribly bad foul.
No, I think the referee understands and gives the, I guess, understanding of the field and the pitch being wet and kind of plays that into factor in terms of the foul there.
When it's a hard foul, it's usually pretty obvious, as we've seen earlier in this match. We're trying to get things started from their own end. Cello will pick up that one over to Damien Kay. Great Ball control there by Damian Kay. Hussein. Over to Danny Medeiros. Medeiros now kicks up as Cadell Thomas with a head of steam. Shoots it, and that's in!
Yeah, what a shot by Cadell Thomas. Breaking in from the left side, comes into the 18-yard box and just fires that one bottom right corner. Similar to Damian Kay's goal on the other side, bottom right corner. Cadell Thomas finds it on the other side to quickly get them up 2-0 in the second half here.
Bit of a disarming play. Did not look like that was going to develop into a scoring chance, but just like that, that ball catches twine, and it's 2-0 Humber.
Yeah, take a look at that one again. Cadell Thomas displaying the speed coming in, and as soon as he has that perfect shot, just takes it, puts it in the back of the net. Humber Hawks go up 2-0. Here's a better angle right there. Just as soon as he finds the perfect angle, fires that one off his feet. Bottom right corner, like we said.
That's the best look we've seen of that goal, that 50th minute marker. Putting Humber up 2-0. Durham looking for a response here. Medeiros will be on that right away, though.
And that's the other thing you got to see with the Humber Hawks. As soon as they score a goal, they don't usually, you'll expect teams to take a little bit of a patient or, I guess, like a safer approach, kind of rest. And the Humber Hawks are the quite opposite. They bring the pressure right back to you. What you said earlier, they attack in waves or layers, one right after the other. You peel one layer, there's the second one waiting there for you, offensively and defensively.
It looks like they could be peeling back another layer here. Keegan Wilson doing a good job hanging on to that one. Pinto. He'll get it back. Humber taking their time here again. The offense started. Hussein using the body to keep that Durham player off the ball. McIntyre. Could be a chance here for the Lord. Shot. That's in. Durham cuts into that Humber lead. It's 2-1 now, the score. A goal off the foot of William Lydon.
Yeah, William Lydon just able to get past the Humber defenseman there, able to chip that one, get in the inside, fires that one. Take a look at that there. Similar to Cadell Thomas's goal on the other end right now, just able to chip that one in and beats Zameta on that to get them on the board and chop this lead into half.
Durham getting on the board with a man down in the second half, 52nd minute. Now Humber's going to look to go back up by two. McIntyre knocked down. Noka helped up by Lydon, who just scored.
Yeah, great to see sportsmanship like that.
Uccello chips it up. That bounds right into the arms of the keeper. Pinto. Another sloppy pass here from the Hawks. They better watch out. All of a sudden, Durham's playing with a lot of life here right after that goal.
Yeah, most definitely. Momentum swings can be so big, and we saw that in the first game between the Fanshawe Falcons and the Surge earlier as the Falcons were able to get on the board.
Cadell Thomas shot just high, but boy, did that have some power behind it.
As just Falcons were able to get on the board after the 10th minute, in which opened the floodgates. But take a look at that chance by Humber right there. Cadell Thomas gets that pass, gets the shot, and just inches over the bar, over the crossbar.
Great view of that shot there. DeBartolo, moving to the outside. Tries to cut into the middle. He'll cross it. It's low. That'll be knocked past the goal line for a corner kick.
And there it is, the Humber Hawks, Andrew. It's so hard to contain them when they get the possession game going and they get the passing perfectly to move the ball up. It's so confusing as a defense or as a blockade on the blue line, just trying to predict where they're going to be headed because they have so many options at every single opportunity.
see what they do here. Uccello's corner looks pretty good off ahead. Mizarski gets the goal, and they put Humber back on top by two. It's 3-1 in the 55th minute.
Alex Mizarski gets it off the header off another Hawk player and just able to get the rebound before anybody and stashes that one away to restore the two-goal lead for the Hawks here just moments after Durham gets on the board.
The center back, Mizarski, getting on the board for the Hawks. Just like that, Johnny on the spot there, right spot at the right time. We got a few looks at this corner kick leading to the goal.
Yeah, the header of De Bartolo finds Mizarski. Humbers does an exceptional job of grabbing those rebounds in close proximity. Another example of that was right there on that replay.
We only saw one goal in that first half, but already three here in the first 10 minutes. Could be another chance here for the Hawks. Uccello running in. Knocked out of bounds. Going to be a corner for the Hawks, so could yet be another goal.
Yeah, Damian Kay and Luca Uccello breaking in. Those are two players you do not want to see coming at you on an offensive opportunity. And Luca Uccello will head back to the corner where he just had an assist, or an apple as we can call it, for the goal for Mizarski.
Heavy rain continues to fall as the corner goes up, and that's in.
Damian Kay finding the back of the net for his second of the game. There might have been a little bit of a collision between a Durham player and the goalkeeper there, which allowed Damian Kay to get the upper hand, but nonetheless, Humber just exploding right out the gates here.
And there was a defender right by Damian Kay there. This could be an own goal. We'll see with this replay. There's the cross. I think that went off the head of the defender.
Yeah, and right there on the...
That's off that of Damian Kay.
Yeah, it did go off Damian Kay, but there you'll see the collision between the goalkeeper and the Durham Lords player, which allowed Damian to get free access to that cross coming in. Second goal of the game for Damian Kay, and 4-1 is the score for the Hawks. And just like that.
Four goals in the first 11 minutes of the second half. Fast and furious pace of the second half continues. Damian Kay, 10 goals on the regular season, already two in the second playoff match.
Speaking of fast and furious, instead of a quarter mile, we live our lives one goal at a time.
Indeed we do. And a correction there, this is the first playoff match for Humber Hawks that they did not have to qualify for this tournament, being the hosts. We talked before about how Humber's averaged 5.6 goals per game, so getting close to that average.
Yeah, most definitely. We've seen them score more than 6 or 7 goals here multiple times, but it just portrays to the game plan of the Hawks where they build from the back on out, where they frustrate you when you're trying to build up that offensive opportunity. They get you on the counterattack, and they make you pay for it almost every single time.
Of course, the highlight with all those goals was an 11-0 win over the Sioux Cougars right here at Soccer Center. McIntyre now. Damian Kay passes back to Uccello. Uccello, he'll shoot. Great save there by the keeper. He had to make a leap to get to that one, but that's going to lead to a corner kick. We'll get another look, though.
Yeah, what an opportunity by Luca Uccello. Gets just a little bit of room for himself. He does not need much room to get that opportunity off, but able to find that. And Garrett Werner,
wow,
spectacular effort to keep that one out of the goal. Another corner for Luca Uccello.
Here it is. This time it's cleared away. Cadell Thomas on it, though. He'll shoot. Right into the mitts of Werner.
Humber double teaming on the offensive opportunity once again for the Lords, and this is exactly what they do. Just make sure they protect their own end. And
Uccello, he's got space. Passed it off. Cadell Thomas looking for Damian Kay. Tries to control it, couldn't quite do it, and that one just goes wide.
Yeah, Damian Kay in a little bit of disbelief after that opportunity. What a wonderful shot there for Kay.
We have a Durham defender down as we get a look at that shot.
I believe Damian Kay and the player there came into contact as Kay was taking a shot. That's Evan Amaral for the Durham Lords, number 14. Seems to be sitting up, getting a conversation from the referee, and he'll stand up with the help of a teammate. But while all that is happening, the Durham Lords will make a substitution. Sean Allen coming on. And it looks like Evan Amaral will come off.
Oh, he's staying in the game for now.
Yeah, it looks like he will. He looks like he is staying in the field, but there was a substitution made. We'll see the player that's coming off shortly.
Fahim looks like he's going back to the bench. So they're going to hold off on the substitution, at least for the time being.
Looks like Humber is going to get some fresh legs. Number 4, Kofi Owa, getting ready to come in. Mistake, number 14, Kofi Owa, ready to come in.
Humber calling for a handball, no call. McIntyre, he'll pass it back. Damien Kay thought about inserting himself in there, trying to get the ball, but he'll kind of back off at the last minute. Durham now trying to get their own attack started. Cello giving chase, putting on the pressure.
And there you see the triangle, three players from the Humber Hawks surrounding the ball.
Miksarski. Got one of the big goals here for the Hawks. Wilson. He's about to got speed. Bowls through a player and he's going to get called for a foul. Cello, long ball upfield, finds Damian Kay. He's going to turn back, try to find an opening. Humber can't get that ball in the box. Hussein, Cello, McIntyre. Off to Pinto, cutting to the middle. He's in the box. Centering pass, no good, gets cleared out. McIntyre knocked down a man, and he's down. It's going to be a free kick the other way.
McIntyre's going to get a yellow card on that, unfortunately.
First card of the day awarded to the Humber Hawks.
Yeah, it was incidental contact. I believe the referee also acknowledged that, but it was just the nature of the contact that was made. And unfortunate incident, but Humber getting ready to switch a couple other players. I believe we're going to be seeing number 8, Federico Leal. Another veteran on this team. Much experienced veteran getting warmed up on the sidelines here.
Federico Leal, the set-piece specialist, checking into this one. this is Isaiah Wisdom. That's Babu Wale checking in.
And Andrew, if you thought the Hawks were difficult to deal with before, it might be a little bit more difficult to deal with considering Uccello and Leal both are on the field now.
Both fantastic playmakers. Bob Wally cutting to the middle. Off to Damian Kay. Can't get that shot off. Watkiss at the sideline. Ball knocked out. It's going to be a goal kick.
Yeah, great sliding effort by Alex Mazarski on that play.
Bob Wally. Leal.
What a move by Leal there to get through the player for Durham. Puts the ball between his legs and fantastic.
Pinto was looking for Uccello, couldn't find him. Here come the Lords the other way. Nice little through ball there. Can't quite get into the box though. That ball be cleared out for a Durham Lords throw-in.
And the one thing about the Hawks right now is that every time they kind of come back into their defensive zone, they're trying to slow the play down and make sure they gain control and create that turnover. Opportunity lurking here for the Lords, Andrew.
Free kick and prime real estate here, right smack dab in front of that 18-yard box, right by that semicircle. Five-man wall being set up here for the Humber Hawks.
And it appears DeAndre Watkiss seems to be the man that might be lining up for this for the Lords.
And this should be a direct free kick. I imagine they go for goal here. Fake, there's the shot. Just a few inches up above the crossbar, but overall not a bad chance.
Yeah, a little fake out there with DeAndre Watkiss and Ibrahim Fahim. Take a look at that one again. Watkiss runs over the ball, Fahim takes a shot, but over the net. And no damage done on that one.
Santiago Muniz, let's check into this one for Damian Kay, scorer of two of the Humber goals here this afternoon.
Damian Kay, what a game he's had. A veteran player on this team, member of this team, winning a national championship previously. And I believe it's right to say that he's done his job and he might be done for the game, but we might be seeing him later, never know.
We'll see how things go, but for now that should be the end of his afternoon. Getting some well-deserved rest. Humber well in the driver's seat here, up 4-1. Trying to add another insurance marker. Muniz getting his first touch. Pinto. Babu Wally. Nice little move to cut down. Cut to the middle, but he loses it. Great job intercepting that pass. Mazarski. Muniz now. Tries to cut to the middle. Passes off to Babu Wally. Player fell down. Leal now. Chips to Uccello, couldn't get a foot on that. Ball cleared out to midfield. A few players running into each other. Humber will pick it right back up. Bob Wally, he's got some space, cuts to the middle. Pass off Uccello. What can he do here? Big save there by Werner, the keeper. But he's down.
Yeah, a little incidental contact with Werner there. Take a look at that one. Baba Wale, sweet feed to Uccello. Uccello with the momentum, trying to put that one in goal, not able to stop himself, and comes into contact with Werner.
Good read there by Werner, making himself big right at the end there, not letting Uccello get off a good shot for the corner. He just kind of had to shoot it right away at the keeper.
Yeah, great aggressive approach. Right you are on that one there. You do not want to be giving an opportunity like that to someone like Luca Uccello. Werner realizing that, making himself big and leaping onto the ball and making sure that attack and opportunity by the Hawks is snuffed out.
Drop kick almost finding its way to the Humber defensive third, but not quite. Oh, Bob Wally, good touch on that. But an even better slide to keep that from being a scoring chance. Durham will try and get this out. Good opportunity here by Watkiss. Be knocked away. Will still be Durham ball.
Take a look at that sliding tackle from Durham once again. Baba Wale coming in. And a great sliding tackle there by Evan Amaral.
It's a great first touch there by Baba Wale. Kind of caught that whole defensive line there from Durham off guard. If it wasn't for that slide, he'd surely be wide open.
Yeah, and Baba Wale, similar to Damian K, Cadell Thomas, anybody up front on this team, such a fast-paced player that can create anything out of nothing so quickly.
But Wally unloads. Big save there by Werner. Didn't have a great angle for that shot. I was kind of at the edge of the box. Iowa passes it back. Pinto. Leal to Uccello. He's going to take their time, just looking for that opening.
As we enter the 73rd minute mark here into this game,
Pinto. Got some space. Muniz passes it back to Pinto. Muniz getting it back, couldn't get into the box. Leal has the edge of the box, tries to pass it off. But instead that will go out of bounds at the goal line for a goal kick.
Let's take a look at the shot from Baba Wale here. Just three Durham Lords on him and gets the shot off, but not able to get that one in.
Still impressive that he was able to do that given that he had three defenders on him.
Keegan Wilson took a hard hit there, unfortunately, on that header opportunity. He's going to go down.
He's right back on his feet, though.
Yeah, what a tough player, and what a key player for the Hawks on the back end is Keegan Wilson. But going back to your Baba Wale comment, like we said, such a skilled player. Doesn't matter if you put 2-3 on him. He's still going to find a way.
It'd be such a threat when you have guys like that coming off the bench with just such speed and skill. We got guys on the other team tired from that first half. It could be quite the dangerous weapon to have on your side.
And that's the thing about the Hawks. Their entire bench, you can count on any player to come in anytime at any given time in any given game and be a factor, and that's what makes the Hawks so dangerous. We have a little bit of a delay here.
About to enter the 75th minute, so we're in the closing stages of this match. Right about ready to get back underway. Here we go. Humber winning that ball back. Here's Leal. He's knocked down, no call. Leal outran that one. He'll retreat to try and win it back. It's back on his foot. Ball on the far side. Uccello tried to go for the give and go. Couldn't connect. Substitution here for either side. While he is Rahimi checking in for the Hawks. And we have Anthony Breeze checking in. Boards. Well, he's Rahimi checking in, rather. Bouncing all around, can't keep it in. It's gonna be a Durham ball. McIntyre. Pinto with it.
Hawks slowing the pace down, spreading the field, and making sure they use the entirety of the soccer field to progress the ball and keep the possession with themselves.
Corner kick. It's taken quickly. Short pass. Crossed in by Leal. Gonna bounce past everybody in that box, but Uccello gives a chase, comes up with it. Muniz is just gonna pass it back, playing it safe. Pass it back all the way to Hameda. Sarsi gets a chest on it. McIntyre now. Babawali tried to get that in the box. It's going to bounce out. Be another corner kick here for the Hawks. We have a couple substitutions for Humber.
Yeah, looks like they're going to be swapping out their goaltenders. Zameta's night seems like it may be done as Ezekiel Carrasco is getting ready.
Keegan Wilson about ready to check back in.
Yeah, good to have him back onto the field. Humber looking to close this one out. Surprising to see Ezekiel Carrasco so late into this game. Usually he starts the game out. Not surprised that he didn't start out today. Humber's goalkeepers have been nothing short of phenomenal throughout the season. As we mentioned, Holger Zameta's save percentage in the regular season was .750. Ezekiel Carrasco not allowing a single goal, keeping a, I guess, 100% save percentage.
Indeed. That one bounces high away. It's going to be another corner kick opportunity as Leal's going to have to run to the other side. In the 80th minute, so not much time left. Humber's got Durham playing their game. it out. Still in the attacking third. Tried to put a shot on goal there. That didn't work.
Aggressive opportunity for Mazarski there.
Here comes the corner. Headed away by one of the Lord's defenders. Shot from wide. Whoa, that did not miss that corner by much.
Yeah, not by much there. Keegan Wilson having a go at it from far on out, but almost putting that one in. Take a look at that one again there. Keegan Wilson gets that one and just lets that one fly. And we'll take another angle there from our GoPro, and Warner with a diving effort there.
Good old Thomas giving chase in midfield. Goes out of bounds. Going to be Lord's ball. Bubba Wally's in the box. Cuts to the middle. Goes back to the outside. Chips it through. Couldn't get it through to one of his teammates. Thomas still with it. Up to Bubba Wally. Couldn't hang on. Pinto. Bubba Wally giving chase, fires, scores!
Bubba Wally, what a shot, breaking in from that far side, gets into the 18-yard box, similar to Cadell Thomas from earlier on, and just fires that one. Bottom right corner once again, able to beat Werner.
83rd minute, comes that goal. Bubba Wally goes to celebrate by the fence there with some of the Humber supporters. Great turnout here considering the not so friendly weather, but we'll get another few looks at that goal.
Yeah, Cadell Thomas puts that ball in there, and then Bubba Wally gets it and just fires that one. Bubba Wally to Leal to Bubba Wally, and in the back of the net.
Leal continuing his continued stretch of averaging an assist per game. He'd gone to six matches this season, got six assists, and there's number seven and number seven.
And that's what it is. You know, talked about the veteran experience in the locker room of this Humber Hawks team. Bubba Wally, Frederico Leal, Luca Uccello, all these guys have been playing together for so long that the chemistry that they have is tremendous for this Hawks team.
Mazarski clears it out. Here's Pinto. Leal now. He feeds Bubba Wally. He's wide open on that far side. Comes into the box. Almost tripped over. Could have been a great opportunity, though.
There's a cross attempt for Muniz, but
a little bump there by Leal will lead to a free kick. Like we're getting ready for another Durham substitution. Rahimi. Federico Leal passes it back. It's McIntyre. Keegan Wilson. He'll get it right back. Czarski now. Humber's trying to play a little bit of keep away here, trying to run out that clock. Looking forward to that full-time whistle. Leo, little chip. He'll get it right back. Had to pass it off. I think that was to Bobby Wally, who can't get it done.
Yeah, he was surrounded by two Durham Lords players that made it very difficult for him to get through to that free ball there.
We're in the final 5 minutes before injury time now.
Yeah, and the Hawks will just look to close this one out, and that way they can move forward into this tournament of the OCAA postseason, Andrew.
John Allen was coming out of this one, and subbing in for him is number 19, Nate Payne. Ball advance to Bobby Wally. We've seen he's dangerous with the ball. What can he do here? Once again, he kind of lost the handle on that one, so to speak.
And
Durham trying to get something going here, trying to end this game on a high note. Del Thomas. Pinto. Leal. Gets it through the defender's leg. Shoots! Just past that far post. Not a bad opportunity. Another look at that shot.
Yeah, take a look at that one there again. Warner just able to somewhat square up to that.
Cut down the angle, which surely made it just a bit more difficult for Leal to find the corner. The clearing attempt goes right to McIntyre. Pinto Mazarski can't quite get a foot on that one cleanly. Awa passes it up, it's Thomas. Two and a half minutes left to go before we hit the 90th minute mark. Shoots right into the midst of the keeper. Wilson passes it up to Pinto. Nunez, just out of the foot reach of Leal. Cleared out, Czarski gets ahead on that one. Durham player giving chase, that's Payne. He'll shoot. That will pose no problem for Carrasco as he gets down to make that save. Pass it up to Hussein.
And the Hawks just making sure that they keep possession and run the time down at this point.
We're about to enter the 90th minute. You can see how much time we have added on into this one. Can't be too long, though, I imagine.
Yeah, I'm going to estimate about maybe two and a half, three-ish minutes, somewhere between there. Not much stoppage during this game. So far it's been flying by pretty well.
Especially those first 10, 11 minutes.
Yeah, most definitely.
McIntyre, Pinto, cross. Looks pretty good, just couldn't find his teammate. Shot there by number 20, Rahimi won't find the back of the net. Instead the goalie, it's cleared out quickly. McIntyre, just a single minute of injury time to be added.
Yeah, like we said, not too much time looks like it's going to be added on here, but like 1 minute sign held up from the umpires and stat keepers downstairs.
Leo blocks that clearing attempt. McIntyre giving chase. It doesn't matter that this team's up four goals with a minute left to go. They're still putting on the pressure as always. McIntyre. There's the full-time whistle. Humber Hawks win their opening game of the Provincials with a big 5-1 win. And Manny, great game all around. Who'd you like in this one?
Yeah, it was a great game all around. Credit to the entire Hawks roster. Damian Kay scoring two goals on the big, big event here on the opening. Luca Uccello coming in big with the playmaking ability. Federico Leal coming in as a stabilizing opportunity at the very end. The entire roster played every single position perfectly. Yes, the Hawks allowed one goal, but you still win 5-1. Mistakes may happen. The weather may be a participant in that, but you played an exceptional game, offense, defense, and you performed perfectly on the field. Humber doing a perfect job in the soccer game.
I think we're both in agreement that Damian Kay is our player of the game for this one, at least on the Humber Hawks side. An absolutely spectacular game by him. Two goals, probably could add another one. The bounce has gone his way, so to speak.
Yeah,
great game by the Humber Hawks, some great possession game, really their trademark.
Yeah, most definitely. A couple of bounces, like you mentioned, a couple of whistles here and there, a couple of maybe offside, but Humber doing a great job continuing on from the regular season into the postseason and just looking to repeat as the provincial champs.
Of course, we all know what the real goal is. The team wants to be national champs. As we get a look behind, you can just beyond our view, there's the 8 national championships on display. 6 of the last 9 seasons, most importantly.
Yeah,
for 7-10.
Yeah, for sure. And like you said, 6 of 9 and 9 of 11 in the OCAA. So banners galore. It's reigning championships for the Humber Hawks here. As the two sides will line up to celebrate and accommodate each other as the sportsmanship from this game.
We'll get
and it will looks like number 9, DeAndre Watkiss, will be player of the game from Durham.
Gets a little bag of goodies there. Danny Medeiros getting awarded player of the game for the Humber Hawks. A great game from the wing. We wonder if he'd finish the game, but he managed to, and he had a great game overall.
Yeah, most definitely. And that might be one of the most contributing factors. Got a injury that seemed like that would take him out of the game. Medeiros takes a little bit of a rest on the sidelines, comes back right in, and ends up finishing the game for the Hawks, and they win 5-1.
Great game by the Hawks to open up this tournament. We will see them next on Friday against the Fanshawe Falcons, who also won their game big this morning as we get a look at the full-time stats. Humber just dominating on shots and shots on target. Corners 9-1. And when it came down to it, they got the saves that they needed.
Yes, the only thing they're not leading on is saves, but rightfully so. Humber was all over possession and passing in the offense in this game, and they did not miss a beat.
We'll get a look at some of the highlights from this game.
Yeah, there's that first goal by Damian Kay where he started the Humber Hawks onto the board. Just absolutely fires that one in the bottom right corner. And just like that goal, Andrew, Humber was able to put 5 in the back of the net. They win 5-1. And you mentioned we see them Friday next against the Fanshawe Falcons. We still got tons of soccer ahead of us. Next up is going to be coming up here is Conestoga versus George Brown in the OCAA postseason.
One of the Humber's big rivals, of course, at George Brown College, the George Brown Huskies. The potential finals matchup, Humber-George Brown, we'll have to see. But at the end, you get looks at some of these highlights. A lot of impressive plays from this afternoon. It's been a lot of fun to watch. Some great play by Humber leads, some great goals. That goal by Cadell Thomas. And that will just about do it for us here this afternoon. For myself, Andrew Milani, my broadcasting partners this afternoon, Zach Benoit, Manny Calra, the rest of us here at the Hawk Sports Network, thank you, and join us soon.